today is the documentarian of his generation, Wolfgang Tillmans. Rose to fame as a documentary-style photographer focusing on London's gay community. He was also a major part of that culture and used many of his friends as subjects. In 1997, he became co-editor of Specs magazine, a magazine that had published his images many times before. In 1998, the installation Total Solar Eclipse Grid won him the Turner Prize. He was the first photographer and first non-English to receive the award. He is represented in London, Berlin, New York, LA, and Paris. He's the artist trustee of Tate Board, has been a professor, and runs a nonprofit gallery for new or glossed over artists to his studio in London. He has countless literary works, exhibits, prizes, awards, and honors. So, Wolfgang, I have a few questions for you.
Yes.
Can you tell us what inspires you?
Yes, of course. Currently the work I'm doing is more abstract. It's more of like a photogram, you say, a Hans Beamer. And it is the process, the pure chemical process, but that was a process that is unlearned from when I began. See, I grew up in Cologne, which is just outside of Berlin. But whole time when I was growing up, I go to Berlin, and this was in the early to mid 80s, and I just became very inspired with during that time. It was the acid house, and it was all the clubs, you know, with all the lights going. I become so inspired by it, you know, and at first I just want to document, you know, the people who I was with at the time. But as I got more and more into it, it was the last thing that I wanted to do. But, you know, and I wasn't pinned as this, you know, as the talented one in the family. But in a way that make me work that much harder.
Interesting. All right. Well, a lot of critics have compared your work to Corinne Day's work. Would you agree with that? Do you think that your work is similar to hers?
You know, yes and no. You know, we both come, you know, and I say that I do play a bit more with my compositions, with my spaces, because I believe, you know, it is the space itself that inspires me. So, you know, if I go on a nature walk and I have my camera, I say, yo, hey, Alex, you know, Lutz, you know, get in the thing. And, you know, and they get in there, you know, and I feel like Corinne Day, she's in the moment, you know, and I am also in the moment, but I feel like what she's documenting is gritty, you know, and in my own certain way I do it, but I also like to play a little bit more, you know.
Okay, so Alex and Lutz, I heard you mention them. Those are your friends.
Those are my good friends.
Okay,
yes.
So Corinne Day also takes pictures of her friends. That's something else y'all have in common. Why do you take pictures of your friends?
You know, it's just because they respond. So it's just they beg for it. You know, I'm just, you know, it's just like, camera, here I am, come at me, and I am there. You know, and we spend so much time together. You know, and it's just that much more, how you say, dynamic, yes. And I feel like that translates very, very nicely to, you know, to the gallery and, you know, to the book too. But, you know, I also like to do magazine spreads. So in some ways I keep that in mind when I'm shooting, when I am editing, if you will.
Okay. Welcome back and thanks for tuning in. With us today, we have three highly respected art critics who have a few things to say about Wolfgang Tillmans' work.
Oh, yeah? Bring them on.
Yeah, I'm excited. Let's see what they have to say.
So Tillmans' first abstract collection of photographs were a Parque edition in 1998. And Parque is an international magazine specializing in contemporary art, with 60 unique works of his that are color negative photographic paper collected by him since he began color printing around 1990. Since 2000, Tillmans has increasingly became interested in these chemical foundations, which were a combination of true darkroom mistakes and years of darkroom experimentation, never really knowing what were going to come out, just showing the movement in the photographs that were left from the silver The series is called Frischweimer. He began creating since 1998, showing the reactions of the photographic paper to light, as well as mechanical and chemical processes. He explains the name Frischweimer arises from the dirt traces and silver salt stains that remain in the paper when developed in a machine that is filled with water and has not been completely cleaned. Images like Frischweimer number 26 has a movement and shows that silver leaving trace in the photograph. And also with Frischweimer number 79, that also shows the same, but with different forms and different movements that create a very well composition for his most of his series with that has 60 unique works, all showing different movements and the silver that reacts to the paper and the liquid and the whole process, which he embraces through all these photographs.
Well, I have two works that I would like to comment on, and the first would be Deer Hirsch, taken in 1995. I found this image very interesting, and I felt as though it was different than some of his other works that he is doing now and that he has previously done before. He usually is involved in party life photography, but this is a more serious approach to his artwork. It's also very interesting to me that he's actually in the photograph, and usually he's taking photographs of his friends. The second image that I want to discuss is Gray Jeans Over Stair Posts, taken in 1991. And this image is more intimate and romantic. Out of all of his photographs, it's a still life image, and the photograph actually makes you think about what happened with these jeans that they're on a staircase. Both of these works are more of his early works, and his approach to them is very different than the work he's into now, like abstract.
Today I'm focusing on Tillman's images of Lutz and Alex, some of which were considered important photographic documents of the 1990s. In 1988, Tillmans became involved in the rave scene and began documenting this emerging subculture. He not only did this in clubs, but also in the everyday adventures of him and his friends. Tillmans' photos of friends have appeared in magazines since 1989. His work has a tremendous impact on the studied casualness of much recent fashion photography. However, Tillmans is not a fashion photographer. He is a portraitist who often photographed his friends. Most well known are Lutz and Alex. His friends as subjects are able to appear very versatile. They can look tough, vulnerable, gay, straight, feminine. They record a specific dimension in our contemporary culture, which many artists try so hard to copy. Even though known as the documentarian of his generation, some of his photos are staged. And Tillmans make this quote, "Staged and contrived photos are just as authentic because in that very moment it was real, it was an experience."
Well, Wolfgang, I think that all those comments were really interesting. I know they mentioned your process, how your work's changed through the years, and even your friends. Do you have anything to say about any of their comments?
Yes. Specifically for what you call my abstract period, which is now. You know, ever when I won the Turner Prize, I became very much in demand. You know, it was like I was a celebrity for 3 days, you know. And at that point, I had to ask myself, you know, what do you, you know, I had to take a step back and say, you know, do I want to do the same thing? But in my mind, I wanted to unlearn certain aspects of the process. And for me, it's the Frischweimer was an experiment, and yet it was a way to do the opposite of what I was doing. You know, and it is not taking no picture, but it is making art, you know. And it in a way, it is still about the case for, you know, is this art or is this photograph? And, you know, I say it is both, you know. And in that way, I wanted to be creating different things, you know. You know, no two galleries have the same work for me. It's all different, you know. Every gallery has different work for me. So in that way, it is a way to sort of take a new approach.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and I know Waleed Beshtifold's work is often compared to yours. What do you think about that?
You know, and he's a good friend of mine, and we often, and I often talk to him. You know, every time I'm in London, I go see. But you know, and when you look at his forms, his forms are very much straight line. You know, much geometry. Whereas me, I do like more fluid motion when I'm doing it. I'm looking for, you know, for example, Zivata drop, and you know, as it expands, you know, I'm interested in making a splash, if you will.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, Wolfgang, I'm so thankful that you got to fly in from overseas. I know that you're such a busy man. And you
have we have time already?
Yeah, and you have a very busy schedule, so I'm so glad that you're able to make it. Do you have any last comments that you want to leave your viewers with, or anything that you have to say about your work or yourself?
But of course, you know, my favorite quotes is from my buddy. His name Chuck Close. He say, "Inspiration is for amateurs. Most of us roll up our sleeves and get to work."